Harbaugh has tried to be front and center from an attention standpoint, doing goofy things like spending a night in a treehouse with a recruit, or throwing the football around the Vatican to upset the religious in Italy, or to do things here in the States where you just go, okay, this is, he's trying to say something right now that he knows will go viral. Harbaugh has been very, very savvy at creating those types of moments, talking points. So he has liked the attention. And because of that now, we wonder, well, why isn't he long for the Michigan job? And I've said this in the past. I think that Jim Harbaugh has always enjoyed going to a place where he will be a conquering hero. I think he gets off on that. And I don't think he has the bandwidth to be at a place for a really long time. I think he burns hot. And he knows that he would rather move on to the next place where he's going to get a little bit more leniency and a little bit less pushback. Think about all of his spots that he's gone to. He went to San Diego, University of San Diego, when, of course, there was no football program to speak of there, and he was a hero. He then goes to Stanford, and he is a hero. He then goes to San Francisco, and he is a hero. And he goes back to Michigan, his alma mater, where he is a conquering hero. But once those places start getting sick of him, he runs. He gets out the door. I'm out of here. He's not there for a very long time. And the same thing feels to be happening right now. This is interesting because A, Harbaugh draws attention to himself every chance that he gets. But B, because by wearing the Bo Schembechler hat and the Woody Hayes glasses, he knew what he was doing. He was positioning himself to be an old school Big Ten big program lifer. And that's what Michigan loves. That's what Michigan wanted. That's what any real college football program would want. A guy that you know is going to be there for 15 years. We're only halfway through that. He's only into year six. And already you can feel the writing on the wall. I'm out of here. So that's why I think Pete Thamel's right. I think the soap opera of will he, won't he, what happens to Michigan, because they're bad. If they were 3-1 instead of 1-3, if they were 4-0 instead of 1-3, if they were at least competitive instead of getting their doors blown off, then maybe it'd be a different story. But yes, right now I do think until the big teams in college football get a bad loss or get an unpredictable loss or until that Final Four is thrown into a blender, yeah, I think Jim Harbaugh is the most fascinating storyline of the college football season.